function.
Well, when you say health facilities, I don't know exactly what you mean. Like health centers that have been set up every day. Yeah, you see, the ideal thing is that once these health centers are established, they are supposed to be handed over to the state, you know, for management and other things. But the problem is, how will you do that without providing the financing in subsequent budgets? It is like it becomes like a mandate, a federal mandate on the states without the corresponding financing mechanism put in place. You know, that's something we need to address. That yes, the ones we have right now, we should make them functional. But I don't think that is the reason to say others should not be established. Because I tell you this, here in Ogele North, for instance, where I'm at, you may have maybe a federal or maybe a comprehensive health center. It's at Agbara, for instance, that is not functioning properly. Yes, an argument should be made that it should be well functioning, it can become functional. But that should not stop me from pushing right there for a health center to be established here in Urugu, where I'm from. You know, but when eventually we have one here, of course it reduces the travel time, you know, for our people here, you know, to get basic health care that they're entitled to, as opposed to going all the way to Agbara. So yes, these are the arguments you have for and against. Some of us are pushing, yes, fund the existing ones, but without prejudice, right there, to our demand of the federal government to also set up in communities where you don't have them, because our people are entitled to this. We contribute so much to the economy of this country. I'm speaking now as a senator representing Delta Central. So to the extent that we contribute so much, we're also entitled to so much.
Back home.